Grüß Gott, meine Damen und Herren, ich möchte Sie sehr herzlich zum Künstlergespräch von Frau Marina Rebeka begrüßen. Das Wichtigste zeige ich einmal her, das ist ein Handy. Wenn Sie so lieb sind, das bitte auszuschalten. Ich mache auch gerne Piep, 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 damit das auch jeder weiß. Wer unbedingt telefonieren möchte, dann bitte in den Musikpausen, da stört man ein bisschen weniger. Und ich möchte jetzt hier sehr herzlich Frau Marina Rebeka vorstellen. Wir werden das Interview in englischer Sprache abhalten. Ich werde versuchen, dazwischen ein bisschen was auf Deutsch zu erklären, wenn etwas unklar ist oder sonstiges. Und ich hoffe, Sie haben viel Vergnügen, vor allem mit den Aufnahmen von Frau Marina Rebeka und mit dem Interview, mit dem Künstlergespräch. Dankeschön. Frau Marina.
Hier?
Ja.
Okay.
Und zwar, die erste Frage ist, how did you become interested in opera?
Oh, yeah, this is a very often question. My story was that my interest with Opera House was not from the opera side, but it was from the ballet side, because we have a very good ballet school in Latvia. And I always, ballet, also tanzen. And I always wanted to be a ballerina. So it's so romantic and they have beautiful dresses, you know, they do all this pirouette. And well, my mother said, you know, it's such a hard really work and all our family has really heavy bones. So there is not really a chance that you would be a ballet dancer. Okay. So I forget it for some time. And then it was a very important day in my life, I could say so. I was 13. And my grandfather said, well, you are big enough, let's go and see opera. I said, what is it? He said, well, let's go and see. So we went, it was not an opera house, it was in a theater, because the opera house was closed for renovation, and it was Bellini Norma. And I remember, for me, it was a kind of a shock, because I was sitting there like, oh, this is, I don't know what it was, but there was something in me that said, this is so amazing, this is so great, this is so classical production, so, you know, beautiful. And after the first act, I came and said, you know what, Grandpa, I'm gonna be an opera singer. And they all laughed because I, yeah, right, you will be opera singer. You know, you didn't study in the music school, you don't know solfeggio, you don't know harmonia, you don't know music history, you don't know anything. How can you be an opera singer? You know, you're too old. So I said, no, we'll see. So, and the whole very long process started because I entered into a half private music school where you needed to do an exam. And I didn't tell anything to my parents. I went there and I said, I want to sing. And they said, how old are you? I said, I'm 13. They said, no, you cannot sing. I said, why? No, you were a little bit childish, you were too early. And I said, you will not believe, but I was so afraid of stage. My feet were like, and they looked at me and said, well, this is something weird. I said, but please, it took me so much to come here, at least listen to me. And I said, okay, well, this girl is desperate, let's listen. And they listened, they said, well, good loud shouting, but might be something maybe come up. So they took me and it lasted for 4 years. We were very enthusiastic because my first teacher was actually not an opera, not a classical singer. He was Schlager singer. But he finished conservatorium as a classical singer, baritone. And he said, well, we have this fantastic pianist who is, she was very famous pianist in the Soviet Union. Yeah, she was playing even for concert for Shirley Verrett, and she could come to work with us. So I said, yes, absolutely, I'm very happy. So the music school took her, and all three of us, we were very big enthusiasts. We were trying something. I mean, I was very young, I couldn't do arias or stuff. We tried some songs, some small things, you know. And then when 17 years came already, I said, okay, so, because I was also, I took the private lessons in solfeggio and harmony to be prepared to go to the music academy. We have only one, Music Academy in Letland. And I went there with my trembling legs. And they listened and said, no, this is not singing, you have no talent, Frau Rebecca, goodbye. Obviously, the whole night, what can I do? 4 years, you know, 4 years, it's a long time. So, but my mother said, you want to sing? I said, yes, I want to sing. So it's not important if you sing in the music academy or anywhere else, let's go. And we entered into this music college, it was called in that time. And I entered with the highest grades, and I was singing Mimi, actually. Very interesting, exactly what I'm singing now in the Staatsoper. And so it went. I mean, I finished that college, music college. By then, the conservatory said, okay, maybe Frau Rebecca is not that bad. Maybe you come back. I said, no. This time I say no. And I went to Italy. And so I finished, I was in first in Conservatorio di Parma, then I went conservatory in Rome. And then I finished, and then I started in Germany. In Erfurt was my first engagement as Traviata. But, you know, this was just the beginning.
Wir hören jetzt einmal eine kurze Einspielung, und zwar, weil wir von Norma geredet haben, natürlich Casta Diva von Bellinis Norma. Bitte.